Okay. And I can do this. Okay. In the libraries of the Lazarus Labs, you learn of an artifact that can sever the connection between our two worlds known as the Crucible. If you can retrieve the Crucible, you can use it to close the well and shut down the Argent Tower permanently from inside of Hell. Okay. Titan's Realm. Pass through the Titan Core. Reclaim the Crucible. How am I doing map-wise? This is a thing.
The age of his reckoning was uncounted. The scribes carved his name deep in the tablets of hell across eons.
Keep talking. Each battle Ashtel in the hearts of the demons, they knew he would come as he always had, as he always will, to feast in the blood of the wicked, for he alone could draw strength from his fallen foes, and I lost all of that. Feast in the blood of the wicked, for he alone could draw strength from his fallen foes, and ever his power grew swift and unrelenting. Yeah. No, I have 3 weapon upgrade points. Stun bomb. I don't know what I'm gonna use. I think I mostly want to kill multiple demons with a super shotgun blast. Oh, explosive shot, cluster bombs. Hit imps. Yeah, sure, let's hit imps. Okay. Guess we're going in. Yeah. Hi. Okay, cool. Where are all the imps? Oh, hi. Right, more rockets could be nice. Hi. So, rockets. Ow. Let me just go back and reload. Good. Point. Robot. Health. Key. Ow. Token, yeah, I've got nothing to do with the token now. I need to go upstairs and get that robot. What are those? Nice of you to leave ammo lying around. Who's coming? Is that a pinky? No, it's just an ugly. That's a pinky. Bam. That seems very closed. Excuse me. There's a robot behind here. Guard, combat support drone. The switch in the wall. I'm stuck! Oh, there it is. That was somewhat annoying. Okay. Oh, okay. Low on ammo, you say, huh? I think I'm good. It didn't open. It did open. What the hell is going on? You're freaking me out. Siege mode? Remote detonation. Let's go with remote detonation. With remote detonation, impulse warhead generate a large rocket explosion. Demons that are hit by the remote detonation will be pierced with additional shrapnel and continue to take damage for a short time. Explosives are now mounted around the rocket, allowing a remote detonation to occur without destroying the projectile. Let's go with that one first. So, where the hell did you come from? Yeah, I finished over there. Target boost. Oh, hi. Yay. Hi. Give me some health! The hell is that? Okay. Excuse you. Oh yeah, that's a teleporter. Let's look around a bit. What the hell is that? What the actual hell is that? Oh, that's the haste. Great, I missed it completely. Never freaking mind. What about the super one? How do I get there? Only from the other side. Okay. Where the hell am I now? Okay, collectible on the left. Okay, production. Collectible on the right. Ow, you son of a... Die a miserable death. I am blowing you up to pieces. Whoa! Excuse me? Health? Health? Oh, you're jumping! Armo! Up there! Oh my god! Oh, you've got a plan! Okay! What is this collectible? Oh, hi. What did I get? BFG 9000 model. King guy. Nice. There's a log. Well, how do I get there? Go down there and then go down and then automap. I think I'm on the right track. Okay. Don't run out the quad damage. Oh my god, this is horrible. Where is everyone? Where is everyone? Bonk. Blue door. Armor piece. Not where I intended to go. Armor. Yellow Skulky. Wait! Come on! Okay, restart. No. What the hell? What the hell was that about? From there to the left, not sure I can see what we're getting at. Ah, there it is. Cyber Demon, Silver Guy. Drop down to the left, find the log. Okay. This door appears to be closed. And that is a blue doll. But I can't open yet. And that's my current target. Okay, back up. Come on. Checkpoint. This looks like an urgent cell. And a log. And that something else. Ugh, disgusting. Invulnerability. Shut up. And I need to get out of here. Right. Oh, wait, there's something here. Ah! Oh, hi! Oh, hi. Ah. The hell was that? Okay, I'm guessing there's supposed to be a lever. I'm guessing there's supposed to be a lever somewhere. And it's not gonna open right now. Hi, Pinky. Can't keep up. Ow. God damn it, move! Sheesh. This place is disgusting. What the hell is this? Does it say anything about this? I don't know what that is. Pinky. Pinkies will charge once the prey is detected using a cortical bone blade that covers their face as a battering ram. They accelerate quickly but have limited control when charging. Their inability to stop quickly or turn makes them vulnerable to charging over ledges or into hard surfaces. Stunning them. At close range, the Pinky has a significant bite which it will use to fend off attackers. They have limited visual perception and rely primarily on pheromone detection to locate enemies. The thinner skin on their flanks does not offer as much protection and should be considered a point of weakness. Null carcasses of Pinkies have been extracted from portals, suggesting that they are considered a delicacy in hell. Ouch. Sucks to be you. The Titan's Realm. After the disastrous Project Lazarus manned expedition MTC-2145/128, it was decided to avoid Kadingir Sanctum until the environment was more conducive to human exploration. The second Project Lazarus manned expedition MTC-2148/177 was changed to a new location, an area referred to as the Great Steppe. The Korax tablets describe this area in detail. Through the Titan's Realm and down to the Great Steppe, where the trophies of victory are kept through the ages, their false idols banished to a wasteland, their towers fallen, their foundations ground to dust, their hallowed halls kept empty as cruel reminders that civilizations shall fall before the ascension of the Great Ones. Fun! We need 6 for this. Die. What do I got left? More armor. What the hell is this? No clue. Guess I'll have to come back to that. Blue door can't be opened. That door is closed. Yeah, backtracking. Okay, shove that thing in there. That's ominous. Of course. That thing shooting at me. God damn it. Die. Okay. Hi. Excuse me. There we go. Ow! Why? God damn it! Right, infinite rounds as long as I'm above a certain armor level. Right. Also, use the goddamn BFG. Another one more. What the hell was that? That's why I came in. Oh, hi. Oh, he's down. Okay, I'm full on BFG, I'm full on just about everything. So now that we've done that, carry on, I guess. Before I do, where did that thing come from? Here. No, where the hell? Where did I come from? Come on! Open the door. Nothing. Oh. That was definitely a thing. Wait, is that the other side of the place where I've been? No. I have to use the teleporter. Okay. That's not a teleporter. What am I missing here? This didn't open. This opened. Teleporter. Locked teleporter. Arena. With jump jets. Okay. kingdom, I'm guessing. Let's play! No? Blue skull. Once I take this, everything goes to shit. So. No bonuses. No more armor. This will probably lock. Okay, no more armor. Let's play, assholes. No? Of course. Spectre? What? The Spectre is the unfortunate result of a misguided attempt to genetically modify the Pinky. Several Pinkies were gathered during the first Lazarus Project's tethering operation, MTC-2146/351. Four of the captured beasts were vivisected, while three of these Pinkies, well, three of these experiments resulted in the death of the subject, one resulted in a Pinky with limited psionic abilities. In an attempt to increase its ocular capacity, the optic nerve of a cacodemon was transplanted into the Pinky. After the operation, the animal was returned to its enclosure to recover. It is believed that the beast was accidentally released from its pen when its keeper, thinking the invisible specter had escaped, opened the gate. Several months after, the first specter went missing. The second tethering operation, 2147016, captured two fertile specimens. Presumably, the original specter wandered into the Lazarus Wave testing facility and was teleported back to hell by a summoner. It is unknown how the specter managed to breed, but the psionic trait has carried to the offspring. Besides psionic invisibility, there are no known differences between the Pinky and the specter. Are you freaking kidding me? If you are one of the lucky disciples who will get to experience the pilgrimage to hell, there are some preparations you must make for your journey. You must make sure all your affairs are in order before leaving. Donate all of your belongings, excluding any security control materials, to a tier 2 advocate and record any final logs you may wish to make. Your savings and assets will be used to fund additional UAC research. For the expedition itself, you may wish to consider sedation. Advocates can get overwhelmed during the transition, and a medically administered balancing agent can help ease the excitement. Lastly, prepare your mind for the wonders you will experience. Seeing the remains of a titan is an experience that will buckle the knees of the most steadfast advocate. If you are lucky, you may not even get to see a live titan. If you do, you must record the sighting immediately and hand your storage device to a scout bot for safety. It is not known if any titans still inhabit the Great Steppe, so if you get the chance to be a sacrifice to one of these massive beasts, take it. You guys are insane. Immune to explosive barrel damage, or swap weapons mod faster. Oh right, four for the weapons. Hello, bye bye. Okay, that did it. What was the other one? Oh, hi. You jumpy. Jumpy, make a jump jump. Cool. Hi. Excuse you.
Lovely. Did I miss anyone? Oh, hi. Show me your head. That did it. Cool. That self could use more ammo. So, clear that place. Now this opens. And takes me where exactly? That looks like an interesting place. Okay, more logs.
None could stand before the Horde but the Doomslayer. Despair spread before him like a plague, striking fear into the Shadow Dwellers, driving them to deeper and darker pits. But from the depths of the abyss rose the Great One, a champion mightier than all who had come before. The Titan of immeasurable power and ferocity, he strode upon the plain and faced the Doomslayer. And a mighty battle was fought on the desolate plains. The Titan fought with the fury of the countless that had fallen at the Doomslayer's hand. But there fell the Titan, and in his defeat, the Shadow Horde were routed.
Sucks. I think I missed something. Pretty sure I missed something. That's the berserk right there. Damn. Okay. God damn it.
Salamo. Hi. Down the hell. Show me ahead. Cool. That teleporter takes me here. Okay, okay. Nah. Out of here. Need one more secret. Oh, I forgot totally about the challenges. Kill a lost soul with another lost soul, huh? Atop the mountain, perform a death from above on the Baron of Hell. Ugh. Hang on a second. Okay, so over here... need to keep going to the yellow door. Is that something? I don't think it is. No, I missed something. Okay. From here... supposed to be a lever? How do levers even look in hell? That. Okay. So that's just a ploy. Still here, and I have no idea what that is. This is the old map. Health I don't need. Ammo is nice. Take me down. And that's just nothing. There's a boost here. Rune upgrade, rich get richer. Oh, because of that. So, got the classic map. Power up, data log, journal. Mega health, last log at the end of the level. How do I kill a lost soul with another lost soul? I'm guessing this is the thing. Olivia Pierce. Before joining the USC, Olivia was open to discussion about her endeavors and beliefs. She was known to have been an avid world traveler, served a 2-year tour of duty with the Global Science Council, and even spent time serving as a missionary in South America, which she noted was a spiritual but frivolous pilgrimage. Since moving to Mars, she had become a recluse, cutting off friends and family to focus on her secretive work on the Lazarus Project. She has rarely been outside of the lab and no longer attends board meetings or any UAC press events. Past colleagues of Olivia have noted this behavior may just mean that she has something spectacular to reveal in the near future. Yeah. No. Seems I have a mod nation and be pierced with additional shrapnel. Not sure I wanna go there. Sun bomb. Doesn't have a mod, launches an electrified projectile that stuns demons with its detonation radius. Must recharge. Why would I do this? Kill 300 demons with a single detonation 15 times. Okay. Well, I got all the exploration bonus, but I haven't gotten the challenges. You know what? I don't really care. Pass through the Titan's Core.